There are good mornings. Those with warm tea and the purple light. Then, there are mornings without tea. Or any light at all. Where you wake up and find your fortune lost. Taken from you. Possibly forever. I used to be Leopold the Golden, Leopold the Fortunate. They called me the grand inventor of greatest engineering. But when my fortune was stolen, I was only the fool. And there was trickiness involved, for the thief had dropped my gold like breadcrumbs through the woods. I left in haste with a note to my wife. Matilda, dearest, I have gone to catch a culprit. I hope to be back by evening supper. Yours kindly, L.
Yes.
How it works. What's this now? Okay. What is this mysterious contraption? Yeah. Before I went deeper, I paused to imagine the thief. Cousin Victor was a suspect. His moral compass twitched like broken clockworks when gold was near. But Aunt Olga had passion. Her pursuits for pure metal were fierce, with no compassion. And Uncle Sergei was the ruthless one, our wolf of the lands. But we used to laugh together. Now we had not spoken in years. It was their loss. But despite this pickle of a trap, I followed the gold underground. I was choiceless, at least momentarily. Some kind of puzzle. This looks a bit dangerous. What's this now?
Look at this.
I approached Cousin Victor's port. He used to be a treasure hunter, splitting the oceans for fortune lost. But a violent storm tore his ship apart. We assumed he was torn as well. But he came back, barely living. He was himself a wreck after this, quiet at home with his wife and children. He declined my offer to build him a new ship. I told him he should not fear to sail the oceans again. He told me I should go away and not come back. Now, perhaps his sight was set on the greatest treasure he never found. My gold. This looks a bit dangerous. Whoa-hoo! Very nice.